You know, my favorite thing about DaVinci Resolve 20 is not necessarily the new features. No, it's the updated features, and Smooth Cut is one of them. It went from eh in DaVinci Resolve 19 to wow, it's actually usable now in DaVinci Resolve 20. So let me show you how to use it, when to use it, and how you can get the best possible results. I'll give you two use cases. Here we go. Okay, so what is Smooth Cut? Well, you can find it here in the video transitions, because yeah, it's a video transition, and you use it mainly to hide jump cuts. For example, use case 1. In a talking head video, for whatever reason, you have to cut out a few frames. Maybe you made a weird sound, whatever. Well, now you have a jump cut, see? But the smooth cut transition will turn that jump cut into a smooth, almost invisible transition. All you have to do is drop the smooth cut transition on the cut, and well, yeah, that's basically it. Now, there are a few settings you can adjust. The length of the transition, where exactly it makes the transition, left, right, or in the middle. The mode, but of course, for the best result, you should set it to better, obviously, duh. And then, do you want it to ease in or ease out or both? But there's also this here, speed warp. And this is the update, the upgrade. This is the difference compared to Smooth Cut in DaVinci Resolve 19. Speed warp makes Smooth Cut significantly better. Let me show you. So this is the jump cut, and this is smooth cut without speed warp, and this is smooth cut with speed warp. That's pretty cool, right? But yeah, look guys, these AI features, they're not perfect yet. They're so new. For example, smooth cut still struggles a lot with moving hands. So you're gonna have to use your own brain power in combination with AI, and then they're actually usable and super useful. Let me give you another example. Use case 2. Let's say that you have a great shot of a view, but in the middle there was a shake or some jitters, or maybe someone walked in front of the camera, and so you had to cut out that part. Well, now you have a jump cut, but smooth cut can make that jump cut almost invisible. Look, and this is the difference between with and without speed warp. Crazy, right? The only problem I see here is down here in the corner. It looks a bit weird. You can see that something happened, but there's an easy fix, right? Just zoom in your footage a little bit. And well, there you go. The jump cut is gone and no one will ever know. So yeah, these AI features, I know some of you think that it's just gimmicks, but you know, it's been like, what, 2 years? Another 2 years and I mean, it's gonna be crazy. Insane what we're gonna see and witness. But anyway, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.